My name is Jacqueline Gray. I was diagnosed June 6th of 2023. May 26th, I went in for a regular routine mammogram. I've been getting mammograms since I was 40 years old. I'm now 48 and got that all done. Then they called me and they said, hey, we want you to come back. We've seen something. When they said they were gonna do a biopsy because I have dense breast tissue, I immediately became frightened. It was June 6th, and that's when a doctor called me and told me that she does see active cancer cells in my right breast. After I hung up the phone, I freaked out. I called my mother. I was profusely crying. Oh my God. I definitely didn't know what to do at that point. So I was very, very scared. Then I had my appointment with Dr. Ahmad. And my first appointment with her, she was very easy to talk to. She basically diagrammed everything for me, told me what could possibly happen, what she's looking at.
So Jackie's case was pretty interesting in the sense that when she came in, appeared to be a very early stage small breast cancer based on the imaging. And when we did some more workup, we found that it was underrepresented on her original mammogram, and so we had to change course.
From that point, the whole pattern changed.
And during that time where the workup is still incomplete, that's the time where women need a lot of support and patience, because it's very natural to just want to rush through and get to surgery, get it out as soon as possible. But because this is such a complicated thing, there's so many factors that go into it, it's really important to get that workup done. And so in her case, we needed to get genetic testing, and that's something that I recommend for almost every breast cancer patient, but especially women who have a strong family history. Any woman that has a breast cancer diagnosed in her 40s should absolutely get genetic testing, because that is a younger age. And then there are certain racial and ethnic groups that are at increased risk for breast cancer and should also consider getting genetic testing.
She started scheduling tests. The ball just kept rolling. She told me I'm gonna see a lot of doctors. And then I made a decision to get a bilateral mastectomy with reconstructive surgery. Just the healing process from that, it was definitely brutal. You know, there's still other things that I have to go through, and I'm just now at a point where I'm feeling good, finally, getting my energy back. You know, I can't sit and just let myself go. I have to fight.
It's really helpful to come in with your support system, you know, at least one other person that can sort of help you absorb the information. And that's one of the greatest things that I saw with Jackie throughout her treatment.
I have a major, huge support team. Oh my goodness, my mom. My mom, I have 5 daughters, my whole entire family, some friends. From the time of my diagnosis, my experience with Dr. Ahmad and every doctor that I've had to encounter has been excellent. I was very trusting, because they had my life in their hands. The future for me is to complete my radiation, and then I have to do 2 small surgeries, and then the icing on the cake is getting my tattoo to memorialize my breast. I'm speaking to you today because if any way to help other women to be very cautious and check, get your mammograms. Just don't think that it can't be you, because it definitely can.
There are treatment options. This is doable, and you just kind of have to get through it, and that there's a lot of hope at the end of it. We know that earlier detection with mammograms has led to improvements in survival. The overall survival for breast cancer, it's very good. The main thing is just to make sure you catch it early.